So I had this great idea for an invention a couple days ago, and it didn't work. Let me actually show you guys what happened, because it was weird. I love soda, but usually when I go to the fridge to get a cold soda, there's none left. So I have to go get a room temperature soda and pour it in a cup over ice, and then it loses all its fizz. It's honestly the worst experience ever. But today, I plan to fix that. I know for a fact there's a way to take a soda from room temperature to cold in under 2 minutes, and I've done it before on this channel. About a year ago, I built an instant soda chiller that when you pour ice and water over the soda and it's rapidly turning, it can cool it in under 2 minutes. And a bunch of you really liked the video, but it wasn't super practical because you have to fill it up with ice and water every time. We're gonna build something you can stick in the freezer and then just turn on. This time, we're gonna make it extremely good. So you can see, like, I've done this before on this channel, and so I kinda thought I knew what I was doing. So I came up with a plan of how it was gonna work. So here's the plan. We take two of these ice packs, we curve them, we put them inside of a circular tube. Then we're gonna take a soda with a little sliding thing that makes the soda go up into the tube. It'll go between two of these, and then there'll be wheels and a motor on the bottom that will spin it really fast for about 2 minutes, and that's gonna make it so all the drink in there chills. And essentially we're replacing the ice and water with two of these ice pack things. So the first thing we need to build is a shell that is circular, and we're gonna do that with some plates and hinges really fast. Okay, now that we have all of these long things, we're gonna connect them with hinges like this. Let's just check the size of this, make sure it will accommodate our soda, and needs to be a little bigger. All right, so this is pretty much the size of our little device here. So now the plan is to do the same thing on the top with hinges, and then we can work on the sliding mechanism as well as the motor that will actually spin the thing. Next thing we need to do is figure out the electronics for this, which are gonna be relatively simple. We have a battery box, electric motor, and wire extension. So now we can connect the extender to this. And now, see that right there spins when we turn it on. We need to find a way to spin the soda using only one motor and one battery box. I'm thinking the best way to do this is to make a gear thing. And as soon as we do that, this thing should now rotate on the top instead of the side. So now we need to build a plate on top of this. So it just needs a little more friction, but that is essentially what it'll do. And then it'll come out of the machine. And then it'll come out of the machine. So that's the basic principle. We have a thing down here, a spathing, and then it'll spin the soda bottle. If we don't have friction, it'll work better. And now it's not strong enough, dang it. You see, like, right here is probably a moment when I should have decided to rethink it, but instead, I just decided to improvise and add another motor to see if I could get that to work. Can we put the soda in from here? Yes, we can. This thing slides over it, and all of the sudden, for no reason, ah! All right, so we pretty much have this mechanism working. So pretty much, sort of. So the next step is to make this thing actually look better. We need to create a cover for the top, and we're gonna actually lock all this together with an array of a round Technic thing. Have the battery box up here like so, and then we'll just be able to switch it on and off. It's all decoration from here. All right, so here we have two of these things that are more frozen now. Anyway, we've finished our creation, and we can undo this by just clicking this little thing right here. And there we have our chamber, and you can see if I turn this on, a little tire spins, and that will spin the drink. So what we need to do is take this thing off real quick and put in the cold packs. But if we throw these in there, all right, so we got both of those in there. So now the slide is attached, and we throw in our soda, and that looks pretty tight actually, so I'm a little scared this won't work, but we'll plug in the back part and flip the switch. Maybe just one. Maybe just do one ice pack, because that's not working. That's okay. We close it like this.
Snap it down here at the bottom.
We get the timer on our phone and we're gonna set this for 2 minutes. I'll put it here so you guys can actually see it. And so when I turn this on, start the timer. 1 minute, 38 seconds. I don't think it's touching the ice pack.
It's literally not. Hold on.
All right. That fits a lot better now. Okay. Right now. Nope, not right now. Now. Yes, this is perfect. You can see it spinning around in there. 9, 10. Okay, I'm a little nervous, guys. I'm gonna set this down. And then all you have to do is just take out your soda. And then I'll just do a little can temperature test here. We have 68 degrees. Dang it! This should've worked. It didn't work. We need a different ice pack. 70 degrees. That's not cold. I don't understand.
So I built this thing. I spent 3.5 hours on it. And it doesn't work. So what do I do?
This part might not make it in the video. I'm gonna take the electronics off of this. I'm gonna take this whole thing, put it in the freezer. All right, so I just took this thing out of the freezer. We can now reassemble the parts that need to be reassembled. Now the soda is inside the machine. Start. 3 minutes, 45 seconds. Let's see what happens. This kind of tastes like you took it out of the fridge like 5 minutes ago. It's been sitting on the counter.
It's disappointing that things don't work sometimes. This, for example, is not the first time I failed on a video. Another example of when this has happened was February of this year. I started a really ambitious project that I was super excited about, and it was a Lego robot that plays the recorder. Let me show you what I'm talking about.
How's it going, guys? Welcome back to Brick Science. My name is Riley, and today we're gonna build a Lego robot that actually helps me learn how to play the recorder. Because as you can tell, I'm not the greatest. So the goal is simple. We're gonna design a robot with little fingers that will essentially do this, and then we'll program it to do different chords, so all I have to do is just blow through it. We're gonna take our EV3, 8 wires, and 8 different motors, and we're gonna see if we can get this, mash it all together, maybe put some Technic in there, turn it into... The first step, we're going to find a layout for these motors.
All I had to do was to design a simple robot that had several motors, and each motor would control a little finger. Fingers would have different orientations programmed to play each note. And you could have the notes listed out in the code so that you could play different songs.
Okay, I think I got it working. If I blow through it. Cool, okay. This is good progress. Okay, so here we are a couple days later. As you can tell, we've been building this for more than 7.5 hours, so new record. Every time I try a new way to block the holes up, it inevitably fails somehow. And I'm realizing that's because of one thing I didn't see when I first designed this, is that these motors should be parallel, and I should raise it so that every one of these should hit it exactly parallel. What would happen is that it would hit this side, and it would hit this side. It would never cover the full hole. So essentially, I just need to raise this a little bit, and then we should be good to keep testing and hope it works. I just got a lot of programming to do, so I'm gonna finish that up. But I think in terms of looks, I just think it needs some work. But for now, we're just gonna call this good. We're gonna finish programming, and then we can finally test it.
And you can see here my attempt at Star Spangled Banner.
Star Spangled Banner.
There have been so many videos and so many projects that you guys have never seen because they failed. And I don't want to showcase my failures, but I'm realizing now, failing is just teaching me to be better at something. And a huge reason for this realization is because, I'm not sure if you guys know this or not, but my most popular video as of right now is my Lego robot that cheats at mobile games. And that project was a failed idea. I had that idea 6, 7, 8 months ago, and I tried to do it, and I failed. And I have one camera angle of that footage still, and I don't know what I was doing, but I did not understand like the battery or like the electrons, how they need to go from your hand to the screen. I still don't quite understand it, but I have a better understanding. And if I hadn't persevered on that video, I would not have a 1 million viewed video today. And I think that's just kind of crazy to think about. And it also kind of goes to show, don't ever give up on like something you think will work or something you think is a cool idea. I will not give up on any of these ideas unless I think to myself, I just don't want to do it anymore. So if you learned anything from this video, I hope you learned that you should never give up on your ideas and that some videos don't have to succeed to become videos. I just didn't have anything else to upload this week.
Guys, comment down below what you think. I'll talk to you in the next video.
So you have to be in contact with the battery?
Guess what, guys? Apparently, your finger has to be on the battery. I'm dumb.